Okay, we are in Kulaba's Sassoon Dock area with the two-time South Mumbai MP, Milind Deora. Milind, appreciate your joining us. The first question, of course, is will you concede this is your toughest election yet? There's anti-incumbency, you're a two-time MP. Plus, there is seen to be a Modi factor in the urban middle class, large Gujarati population in your constituency, large Marwadi population, middle class area. Are you worried about that or not?
But I'll tell you what gives me faith more than even the last election. In this election, for instance, even those who are supposedly pro-Modi constituents, the Diamond Merchants Association, various trader associations, not only are they just supporting me informally, but they've had public meetings where they've openly expressed their support for me.
But when I was in Jhaveri Bazaar today, they said, we want change, we want Modi, apki bar Modi Sarkar. The market rumor is that Milind Deora has done a deal with the BJP Shiv Sena to ensure that BJP does not contest against you, Shiv Sena contest. Is there a deal? Come on, Milind Deora, you're laughing. Is there a deal?
I find it so funny because Shiv Sena people say we've done a deal with MNS to field the MNS candidate. MNS people say we've done a deal with Shiv Sena. Listen, ultimately, if there's why people have fielded candidates, why has BJP given, why has Shiv Sena kept this seat? That's frankly for Shiv Sena and BJP to answer.
It has often been said that Milind Deora and your father Murali Deora, both of you have friends in the BJP Shiv Sena. Your father struck a deal once with Bal Thackeray, was the rumor. Now you have struck something with Uddhav Thackeray and the BJP. Not true.
Rajdeep, I'm laughing. I find it funny because I'm very happy to say that yes, I do have friends across the political spectrum. But to say that I've struck a deal and I've got a Shiv Sena candidate and I've put an MNS candidate, whatever the rumors are, all I can say is they're very flattering rumors.
Is there that fear of a Modi wave in places like South Mumbai?
I think it's fair to say that politics is very local, and regardless of who someone wants at a national level or who someone doesn't want, it also depends on who the local candidate is, what they're offering.
Is there another factor which troubles you this time? Aam Aadmi Party factor. The AAP could also be targeting the urban middle class?
I don't discount any political party. I never did in the past also. Ultimately, what happens is also who the candidates are. And Even my AAP candidate, she fought against me 5 years ago. Frankly, I remember she spoke 5 years ago about the fact that she would work with whoever won the election and would be around for 5 years. She's been completely missing in action.
Okay, just a couple of quick questions. How is your campaigning style different to your father? What's the biggest difference between Milind and Murali Deora?
The biggest difference is the fact that South Mumbai has changed considerably.
Do you have to buy votes? Do you all have to buy votes?
No, not at all. Your work should buy you votes. I think it's very, very insulting to say that people can be bought and they vote based on money.
If you lose this election, will you go back to your music and the other things that you really like? Come on, is that what you really like, or do you really enjoy all this politics? Is Milind Deora at heart a musician and a politician only later?
My passion for music is something which is going to stay whether I'm an MP, whether I'm a minister, whether I'm something else in politics.
What's your song for this campaign?
My favorite tune at the moment is, I'm a huge rock music fan. I'm primarily into a band called Kings of Leon.
Okay.
And there's a beautiful song of theirs called Beautiful War, which in some ways is kind of what politics and what elections are about.
Okay, you're very far away from the Kings of Leon. You're here in Sassoon Dock in a fish market. All the very best.
Thank you.